In this video, we'll show you how to configuration I/O functions without writing a single line of code.
Every HMI design in ADE comes with this I/O configuration page. This page has all the I/O functions that our products support. The central figure shows the physical location of each I/O pin. Keep in mind that this page is only visible in ADE and will not be downloaded to your actual HMI design.
For user-defined I/O functions, there are three groups. They are GPIO, PWM, and ADC. In ADE we offer widgets of various styles. However, this tool allows you to change the design to create your own and make the HMI design distinctively yours. Let's see how simple and straightforward this task is. Before we move on to the next group of I/O, one important notice must bring to your attention. Each I/O pin must be enabled before it can function. You can enable this I/O pin by clicking the dot next to each I/O pin name or checking the enabled box in the pin configuration tab. This group of I/O pins offer GPIO, PWM, and input capture mode.
If programmed to be GPIO mode, this I/O offers the same function as the previous group of I/O.
Once the I/O pin is configured to PWM, a PWM frequency adjuster is available for setting the PWM frequency. Make sure you program the duty cycle by binding a register. This bound register dictates the duty cycle percentage. The input capture mode put is to measure the occurrences of an input event and the time span these occurrences take place. The input event can be defined as a rising edge, a falling edge, or both edges. The count register is to store the number of the occurrences. And the elapsed time register is to store the time span when these occurrences take place. Our control board periodically measure the inputs and update the results in these two registers. Once an update happens, the callback function is activated. These ADC pins can serve as the GPIO or analog input. The GPIO mode offers the same functionality as other GPIO pins do. For analog input mode, the pin serves as the source for ADC. These two pins are for the system level function. The backlight register is a system register and it is to set the brightness of the LCM. Another setting you can do is the screen lock time. It is to set the time of inactiveness for shutting down the backlight of LCM. The next system level I/O is RDC. RDC stands for real time clock. RDC can provides date and time. Users can bind the date and time information to registers for further manipulation. Our I/O interface offers two UART ports for communication. Users can set the baud for each UART to fit the communication bandwidth requirement. Keep in mind that this I/O configuration page is a system page and will not be downloaded to your HMI design. All the I/O functions can be set without programming at all. This is a huge value proposition to our customers as our solutions cut the development time and risk significantly. Thank you for watching. ADE